Hello everyone, welcome to NRH channel. Dear students, in last class we have completed the exercise number 6.3 from the lesson triangles. Now today we are going to discuss about the very important theorem number 6.6. Now beginning of this lesson you have seen the one very important theorem, that is, if a line is drawn parallel to one side of triangle to intersect the other two sides of distinct point, then the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. But see here what they given, the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles. See what they given, the ratios of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratios of their corresponding sides. The square of, see how they given, is equal to the square of the ratios of their corresponding sides. About the areas they given here, the ratios of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratios of their corresponding sides. Now I will draw the diagram, then you will get the idea. So take the two triangles. Triangle ABC, ABC, one more triangle DEF, DEF, they given both areas are in the same ratio. Yes, you have tried the proof. So remember that statement, children, statement is very important. So see how to prove here. First you have to write the given, what they given in the statement, what is the given. So let triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, both triangles are they given the similar, then what you are going to prove here, to prove, see, area of triangle ABC divided by, see, AR is denoted by the area of triangle DEF is equal to the square of the corresponding sides, means see that the corresponding sides means here AB divided by DE, correct, whole square, because square is the given, is equal to, see, BC divided by EF whole square is equal to, one more side, AC divided by DF whole square. You are going to prove the this one. Clear, children? Yes. Little do the construction here. See what is the construction. Draw the two line perpendicular here, give the name AM, and here perpendicular N. Draw AM perpendicular to BC, and one more is AN perpendicular to EF, correct. Then see the proof. Yes, proof, you know that. What is the formula to find the area of triangle? Area of triangle formula, half into base into height, correct. So see, the they given that area of first triangle, area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF, correct, because children they given the area of the ratios of the triangle. So area of the first triangle divided by area of the second triangle is equal to, see the diagram, see what is the formula to find the area of triangle ABC, what is that, half into, what is the base here, BC into height AM, correct, BC into height AM, divided by, see here are the triangle DEF, half into, see which is the base, EF is the base, height is the DN, correct. So half into, what is that, EF into height is DN. So this is again the equation 1. So next come to the in triangle, see in diagram, in triangle ABM and triangle DEN. See here in these two triangles, angle B is equal to angle E because they again both are similar. So both are similar means their corresponding angles are equal. Similar angle M is equal to this side angle N because each is the 90 degree. So you can say that both triangles are also similar. Yes, correct, by AA similarity criteria. Because these two triangles are similar means their corresponding sides are in the same ratio based on the basic proportionality theorem. So in triangle ABM, in triangle ABM and triangle ADEN and triangle DEN. Correct. See that. Next, see angle B is equal to angle, that's angle E, because corresponding angles of, you have to write the region, corresponding angles of similar triangles. Correct. Then angle M is equal to angle N because each is 90 degree. So therefore, what you can say that triangle ABM is similar to triangle DEN. By which rule? By angle similarity criteria. Correct. So then this is a similar means you can write the corresponding sides are in the same ratio, that is AB divided by, what is that, DE is equal to AM divided by DN. So this is the equation 2, correct. Why? You have to write the reason, because corresponding sides of similar triangles are in the same ratio. See that again see that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, they given. So again, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, they given. So these two triangles are similar means what are their corresponding sides? So AB divided by DE is equal to, take the base here, BC divided by EF. BC divided by EF, because corresponding sides are in the same ratio. So this is equation 3. Now see, from equation 2 and 3, compare the equation 2 and 3 here. See what you can do here. AB, AD get cancelled. AB, AD get cancelled. What will get here? AM divided by DN is equal to, what is that? BC divided by EF. Correct? Now this is the, now this one you have to put in equation 1. So these values you have to put in the equation 1. See what will get here. See in equation 1, half get cancelled. Correct, children? Now see the next BC divided by EF. Correct? See here, AM divided by DN means what is that? BC divided by EF. Correct? AM divided by DN means BC divided by EF. This value you have to put that. Where is the AM divided by DN? See that AM divided by DN means what is that? BC divided by EF. This value you have to put the here. So what will get the here? So area of triangle ABC divided by
area of triangle DEF is equal to, see what is the BC divided by EF, BC divided by EF, correct, into, see AM divided by DN means, AM divided by DN means what is that, here I have to put the value, that is also BC divided by EF. So is equal to, so multiply BC into BT, BC, BC divided by EF whole square. So 1 you got the whole square. I hope you understood, children. Now see the, here I'll do that last. Now, in the beginning, see what you are going to prove here. Either their corresponding sides are in the same ratio means. Now first we have seen that. See, this is equation 4. Now combining the equation 3 and 4. See, combined equation 3 and 4. See what you'll get here finally. Shall I do the last? See that their corresponding, see here, their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. AB by AD is equal to BC by EF. Now square is equal to, this also square, and this is equal to square. So combining the 3 and 4, finally what you'll get here. So area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF is equal to, see finally you will get the combining, after combining the equation 3 and 4, AB divided by DE whole square is equal to BC divided by EF whole square is equal to AC divided by DF whole square. So hence proved. See, either their corresponding sides are in the same ratio, one ratio proved, that square means remaining also will get the square only. So like that you have to prove the children. So this theorem is very important for the examination. For 5 marks or 4 marks they will ask the such question. But in the exam they will give that only statement. So you have to prove the by taking such diagrams. So this statement you have to remember. In the next class we will see the examples based on the this theorem. I hope you understood, children. We'll see in the next class. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.